Откуда вот появляется, я вот...
Where did it come from? I think information comes from childhood, still.
Меня когда учил, вот мой учитель, Ербулат Тулепаев, мой учитель, да, он, когда меня учил, когда молодой был, он говорил.
Ербулат Тулепай was my teacher. He used to say, before putting a color, you should think about what this color is responsible for on the canvas. This brush stroke placed on the canvas should also be responsible for something. I can't just take it mechanically. I have to think how it harmonizes with other colors. How will this affect the viewer? Where is the entrance to the painting? Where is the way out of the picture? There are many canons in painting. These canons must be kept in mind.
Где вот это вход в картину, где выход из картины? Вот это много-много вот каноны есть вот в живописи. Вот это канонов все надо соблюдать, все надо в уме держать.
There was once an endless sea framed by the Aral steppe. One could stop the movement of the ice at only a flying bird and a lonely yurt. There, they say, the Kazakh light was born. With countless shades and overflows, sounding in unison of waves and rain, the movement of the free-flowing dune. Quiet as snow and furious, like the voice of the bareback stallion, Kashagan. This is how the little Balakai Alpesbai saw it. Looking for the first time into the Shanrak, into the opening of the yurt, leading straight into the sky. And he planned to fly there into the world of endless light, into the world of the game of colors. And the little boy realized that he was an artist. But in the Kazakh language, the word suretchi, artist, is not often used. Therefore, Alpesbai and his desire to paint looked exotic for everyone. And so it was. Just needed to turn on your imagination. In reality, as a child, he saw the works of the artist Kulbay Abulkhanov and followed him. Yes, and of course, the caravan. It was in Aral.
Это всегда кочевники как общий образ, да?
These are always nomads, as a common image of nomads in the center of the cosmic desert or steppe. They don't just run somewhere, they keep on their way. These are two different things, because if they keep going, you have the ultimate goal. You understand where and why you are going. You are in finding your home, your peace. This is the whole journey. In general, Alpesbai Kazgulov's paintings are a journey. Very low horizon, and people are somewhere below. And people walk, of course, they have a path, but this path is alarming. This is such a theme of Exodus. The theme of Exodus was typical of the late 20th century. It is biblical story, and this practically in all his works can be traced. This is his credo, this is his vision.
И это практически во всех его работах прослеживается. Такое вот это его кредо, да, это его видение такое.
Много вот из этой серии из цикла тоже много работ написал. Караван это движение.
I painted a lot from this series, from this cycle of works. A caravan is a movement. A caravan is an open space. A caravan is an energy that moves. When I draw a caravan, they are not just caravans. They come down from somewhere from heaven. They descend from heaven, then the mountains. The mountains turn into people. They seem to descend from space. So they go. Life goes on. Life goes on. Time goes on. I found a way to express my thoughts. Found and worked on it for a long time. I painted hundreds of caravans. I tried to make sure that no one was like the other, both in color and composition. And in terms of dynamics and plasticity, in harmony, they are all different.
И по динамике, по пластике, по гармонии там они разные все.
Because our world is so diverse, so endless, so incomprehensible, and therefore we cannot state anything concretely. But we can feel, experience this world, this life, at the level of mentality, emotionally. And that an emotional painting, full of passions, I see in Алпысбай Казгулов's works.
Боль за судьбы страны, за судьбы народа. И вот
pain for the fate of the country, for the fate of the people. Алпысбай Казгулов is one of the sharpest masters of the palette who expresses this. He has a vision. He grew up on the Aral Sea. So such pain of the Aral Sea left an imprint on all works. Even lyrical, not just landscape painting. This is a clear sense of tragedy in him.
Не просто такое пейзажная живопись. В нем есть вот это явное ощущение трагизма.
If the artist does not suffer from this theme, along with this picture, it will not work. Therefore, one must be present there himself. I think so. His canvases are electrified with energy. Numerous paintings by the artist, abstract improvisations, Turkic historical motifs, Aral landscapes, portraits. And all these is in the unimaginable circles of color and the cosmic inaccessibility of the imagination.
Искусство делает зрителя соавтором, соучастником.
Art makes the viewer a co-author, a participant, invites the viewer to continue the image, to work on the image. The artist begins, but does not end. He finishes it himself. He invents it himself. In abstract painting, there is practically no plot or it is completely minimal. This means that the viewer is affected by color, rhythm, tone. It's like music. Absolutely musical devices that suddenly appear in painting. And therefore, when meeting with the works of Алпысбай Казгулов, you can experience different sensations, different impressions, as in music. My friend, composer Куат Шильдибаев, says, it's easy for you. You mix the paint and draw. But it's hard for us, because the keys start here and end here. It's hard to compose music, and he doesn't know how difficult it is to get this color, this tone. There was such a case. I did not perceive one artist, his work. I didn't like his paintings. But when I saw one color in his paintings, which I had never seen anywhere, never from anyone, after that, I started to respect him.
Увидел один цвет, который я никогда, нигде, ни у кого не видел такой цвет. После этого этого художника я зауважал.
This is actually right. When it is not the style that is important, but the personality of the artist, his personality, expression, there is another one here. It boosts color, it shapes shape, he reinvents it, he transforms Art Nouveau, and knows that this is generally characteristic of artists of the 20th century. I am my own style, I am my own theory, I have my own theory of color, my own. Алпысбай Казгулов graduated from the School of the Graphic Arts Department of the Abay Kazakh Pedagogical Institute. 7,000 paintings, most of which are scattered across galleries and private collections in Europe, Asia, America and Russia. Among the admirers of his painting, there was Chingiz Aitmatov, the Belgian Prince Laurent, Patricia Kaas, Gerard Depardieu, Laima Vaikule. Personal exhibitions were held in Russia, Great Britain, Japan and Turkey. He was awarded the prestigious European Union of Arts Prize.
Мы сейчас какого-то художника вот при жизни вот говорим, вот это хороший художник, его картины там.
We are now talking about some artist that people buy his paintings for big money, print everywhere, show everywhere. But in 100 years, maybe an artist that no one talks about will become the greatest artist. Who in 100 years will be recognized great artist, no one knows. In London, I went to many museums looking for Russian artists. Of the Russian artists whose works hang in the museum, Natalia Goncharova. I looked, the picture was painted primitively, When she painted these pictures, she did not even think that this picture would hang in the London Museum. She was just drawing. Then no one knew that of all Russian artists, Russian woman artists, the most expensive would be Наталья Гончарова. Through the centuries.
Она просто писала все. Тогда никто не знал из всех русских художников, русских женщин-художников во всем мире самый дорогой художник будет это Наталья Гончарова.
And this is precisely the most difficult thing in an artist, passing reality through his life, and gives us these images. The artist's paintings are similar to step mirages due to their color saturation. Perhaps this manner contributes to the transmission of thoughts in the artistic dimension. The great Chinggis Aitmatov once wrote about him. Despite the seeming limitedness of the theme of the step, aul and courtyard, Alpazbay pushes the boundaries of our consciousness, somehow incomprehensibly giving his paintings a truly cosmic scale.
Творчество прежде всего связано с Всевышним связано.
Creativity is primarily associated with the God. An artist alone, he cannot create works of art himself. If there is no presence of the Almighty, try to paint a picture, but it does not work. I suffer for several days. Why doesn't it work? I work, I try, I draw, draw, draw. I just walk away. I looked, and the picture was finished. As if someone came and finished the picture. This is a presence of the God.
Это есть присутствие Всевышнего.
Looking at the works of Kazgulov of different years, you can see how the style and directions of his work changed. From now on, one of his favorite abstract images in painting is a play of color, saturated with unexpected coloristic transitions of dynamic movement of the brushstroke. In the history of Kazakh painting, there are not so many artists who are engaged in abstract painting. And here is Alpazbay Kazgulov, who turns to this direction of painting. Abstract paintings are very difficult to draw, because they pointlessly tell people something in the language of color and lines. It is very difficult. An abstract painting has many possibilities, everything affects. Your mood, your health, the weather, everything.
На улице вот эта погода, все влияет.
У Казгулова романтизм байроновский. Он такой трагический.
Казгулов has Byronovsky's romanticism. He is so tragic. This is a kind of German romanticism. Very unsettling, on the verge of a premonition of the apocalypse. Of course, this comes from the experiences of the tragedy that our country, our people experienced throughout the 20th century.
В моих картинах вот я замечаю, вот, какое время происходит все это.
In my paintings, it is very difficult to determine the time when this happens. This happens in the 19th century, or in the 18th, or 21st century. It is very difficult to define. For example, abstract paintings, you can't say that it was painted by a Kazakh or a Kyrgyz, purely European style of writing. Although I am Asian, but the very manner, compositional structure, even other thoughts do not look like a nomad.
сам цвет, вот это композиционный вот этот строй, даже вот мысли иногда вот это совсем по-другому. Не похож как бы на кочевника, не похож.
I would call it magical realism, especially his work of the last 10 years. He's just one of those artists who are looking for themselves and experimenting, and are not afraid to be free. What is Alpis Baykazgulov for me? This is such a mysticism, and magic, and mystery, and an invitation to travel to other worlds. Space in his painting. This is space. This is such a universe, closed from man, but meanwhile, it is precisely the human universe. Alpis Baykazgulov, who grew up on the shores of the Aral Sea, is very keenly experiencing the tragedy of the Aral Sea, and any cataclysm, an unheard-of event, all this plunges him into shock, into powerful experiences. This is what his canvases are based on. His style and directions of creativity changed, but the play of color, expression, softening of color overlays and transitions, allowing to show picturesque airness, remained unchanged. The universe is always present in all its diversity, and how small the figures of people and animals seem. How touching and defenseless they appear before the power of nature.
Человек, образ человека, он действительно очень маленький.
Man, the image of man, he is really very small. And in this reflection, the picture of the world is very clearly visible, the Kazakh picture of the world, where a person is a grain of sand in this universe, and we live in our gene code, in our collective unconsciousness. There is this feeling that in the world we are not the masters of the universe. In front of this step, in front of this sky, in front of the great universal harmony. This comparison, the difference in the scale of human life and the size of the earth, space, fate in the paintings of Abulai Kazgulov looks incredibly unreal. And in this sense, for me he is a romantic. It is precisely in the pictorial romance of the 19th century. This is the composure of man and the world, man and fate. And although the human world is small in comparison with the universe, but he is not afraid to follow the path of life. He is not afraid to look into this abyss.
В одной книге я прочитал. Қалай жазғаныңды?
I read it in one book. When I read this, I immediately understood everyone is present in creativity. When I paint, I always think. My parents taught me, gave me knowledge, so that I could become an artist. My teacher taught me that I should do better than a teacher. Great masters, how they work. For example, Rembrandt, Vermeer, how Cézanne worked. As Matisse had painted, I have to look up to them too. They are also present in creativity. Naturally, the Almighty present. If he is not present, then the work will not happen. I am sure of that. If there is no of its component, then there won't be a full painting.
Если присутствия нету его, произведения не будет. Я в этом убежден. Если одно из этих не присутствует, тогда вот не будет полноценной картины.
The artist's cult ritual is worship of the great road of the Turks, perpetual motion, eternal return to yourself. Alpis Baykazgulov thinks modernly, but the thoughts he touches are as old as the world. Best of all, the meaning of the artist's work was expressed again by Chinggis Aitmatov. Why do we live? What is love? Spirit or matter? Is man a part of nature or its crown? Art takes it upon itself to ask the same questions endlessly. Great art gives answers to them.
Я пишу свои картины уже 43 года.
I have been painting for 43 years. For 43 years I realized that there is a key to the secret of color. This key is at the top. If the Almighty wanted to give this key to the artist, he gives only that artist, who is worthy. I will or will not receive this key, I don't know yet. I think Matisse received this key from the great artists. Cézanne got it. Whether we will receive or not receive is still unknown, but during my lifetime, I would like to receive this key, if there is such a key. Of course, these are thoughts at the level of feelings.
При жизни хотелось бы получить такой ключ, если бывает такой ключ. Конечно, это все на уровне вот чувства идет.
Он очень смело и свободно обращается с цветом. Он не боится соединять разнообразные несоединимые цвета. Он иногда.
He is very free and bold with color. He is not afraid to combine a variety of non-combinable colors. He sometimes refers to color disharmony, and sometimes, on the contrary, his works are full of harmony. Silvery shades, which I always find in the space of the steppe. This is the color of feather grass, the color of the sky, but not summer, but such an autumn sky.
Только иносказательное, символическое, условное. И вот в этом, мне кажется, ценность его живописи в том, что художник Алпысбай Казгулов не копирует натуру, а преображает ее, интерпретирует, переводит ее в знаковую такую систему.
Такой мазок очень размытый, да, переходящий в несколько слоев.
Such a smear is very blurred and passes into several layers. There is no clear line between shades. It works great with color, feels color great. Moreover, the color is dramatic. His palette is not cheerful, it is dramatic. But how skillfully he gives a smear. One stroke that turns the whole perception of the picture. Few of his peers know how to show color like that. Relief, airy, fiery. He consciously does whatever he wants with us.
Мало кто умеет так подать цвет. Рельефно, воздушно, да, я бы даже сказал, иногда огненно. Он делает с нами, со зрителем, все, что хочет.
Все время работаю, сколько хватит времени.
I work all the time. How much time? How much strength? How much life I have? If a person, an artist, thinks well, if he does more good to people, then his work will not end. When Мамбеев came here, he said, Алпысбай, you have painted more than 7,000 pictures. You have 5-6 good pictures left to paint. Sometimes I think I have to paint 5 or 6 good pictures to leave a mark on art. I think so all the time. Sometimes I think maybe I have already painted these 5-6 paintings.
Все время так думаю, но иногда думаю, может я давно написал, может эти картины.
Алпысбай Казгулов paints about our life in a diverse and unpredictable manner. Everything that surrounded him in childhood was reflected in his work. This is his life. He is like a chronicle of his history, his travels across the great steppe. Can you hear the caravans wandering along the path filled with mirages? The artist slowly follows to the home of his heart and his beginning. And we understand this.